result of this sin nature, because God is holy and God is just. The Bible says that the wages of sin is death. Rebels against God, that defies His word, that doesn't want to have anything to do with it from God's word. This is a rottenness that goes to the very core of our being. The Bible says there's none righteous, no, not one. Many people think that they're good people, and yet they still come here and have an abortion. Many people think that they're a good person, that they're just in your way.
Savior, His name is Jesus, the I am.
than I am. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. What that simply means, there's only one way to be reconciled to God. There's only one way for your sins to be forgiven. And know this, if you don't know Jesus, you are dead in trespasses and sins. There's only one way for your sins to be forgiven. There's only one way for you to be reconciled to God. There's only one way for you to be at peace with God. You must be born again. Cry out to Jesus. And thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For all who call upon the name of Jesus Christ the Lord shall be saved. The question is, when you hear the gospel, when you know your condition, and that you are a creature of wrath, what are you going to do about it? Are you going to try to run and hide? Or are you going to cry out to Jesus for mercy and for grace? Today is the day of salvation. Today is the day of deliverance. Know this, there's coming a day when there will be time no more. There's coming a day when Jesus returns. He's going to judge the world in righteousness. That should concern you. If it doesn't, check your pulse and make sure your heart's still beating and you still have breath in your lungs. It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. One day, the books are going to be open.
State that we think that we got all up.
They think that we're all going to be just fine. Isn't that the pack of lies that we are fed from this wicked world? As we read earlier, blessed is the man who walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. If you're listening to the people that are coming to your work, to call the wrong people, it's time to pick up a Bible, pick up the King James Bible, and get to know the God of all creation. He can change everything in your life. He can turn you around from being a hell-bound, hell-deserving sinner into a heaven-bound saint who loves the Word of God. When the Lord gets a hold of your life, when God takes out your heart of stone and gets your heart of faith, know this, that everything changes. When God gets a hold of you, the Lord, when He regenerates your life and spirit, you'll have a longing for the things of God. If you don't long for the things of God, if you don't hunger and thirst for righteousness, then you will be filled. If you don't know God, you need to get right with God. Today is the day of salvation. You might have blown it. We've all sinned. We've all messed up. We've all done things that we shouldn't do. We need to confess that sin before God and get right with God. And thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thy heart that God hath raised them from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Know this, you might have today, but you give your life to Jesus, and you become a new creation in Christ Jesus. This is the work of God. The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away, behold, all things are become new. Know this. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Somehow, in some way, for some reason, we think that we have to worry about tomorrow. And yet, when you give your life to Jesus, there's many women that get an abortion because they're hopeless. They feel like there's nowhere else to turn. But know this, when you give your life to Jesus, everything changes. God provides for you in ways that you could not provide for yourself. Know this, man, abortion is not just abortion. There's other sins that go along with abortion, such as pedophilia, and rape, and trafficking, and incest. They don't want to have any consequences and responsibility for their actions. But that's not the way God's made us. God has made us to have consequences. We need consequences. We need boundaries. We need restrictions. We need to be kept in mind. This is the Word of God. This is the value of the Ten Commandments. The Word of God, the law of God, is a boundary. It helps us to keep from going to places where we don't belong. If you don't know Jesus today, turn to Him, cry out to Jesus. If you hear this message in that clinic, get up out of that clinic and run out of that clinic and cry out to Jesus. Beg for His mercy and His grace. Ask Him to forgive you of your sin and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. This abortion is murder. This abortion is unnatural affection. This abortion is not normal. This is abnormal behavior. We don't have a right to take away the life that God has given us. The only right that we have is when God gives life and God gives that life to us, we have the responsibility to take care of that child. Fathers have a responsibility to take care of their lives. Another reason why people have abortion is because people shack up. People would rather be boyfriend and girlfriend than husband and wife. These things should not be so. God calls that fornication. God calls that fornication. When you have sex outside of marriage, God calls that fornication. When you're married, you have a relationship with another woman. That's called adultery. These are the things that support abortion. And there's more to it than third day. If you know and believe and understand that Jesus is the Son of God, then know that He's your Lord. Cry out to Him. Cry out to Him to save you. Turn to Jesus and live, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son,
truth and love.
That whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life.
We don't share Jesus.
I shared Jesus when I told my God.